Hi, Scorpios. Let's get your messages this week. Let's see what's coming through for you this week. This is for my Scorpios, their person. Let's do one more shuffle here. Scorpios, person. Let's get the person's energy coming in here. Pop, first thing out. Somebody's wanting to take a leap of faith. Yes, they're wanting to take a chance on something. What else is hanging out? Ooh, they want to feel safe taking that chance. Yes, that's about a safe haven, guys, and believing in magic, because that's actually a little unicorn back here. So somebody is very optimistic and they're ready to take a leap of faith, but at the same time, they're trying to calculate or evaluate how safe does this feel. Doing this, I want to know if I'm gonna hit the ground and crash and burn. That somebody's under a spell. They're very enchanted by you. It also may be indicating this card that we are maybe talking long distance. Let's see a little bit more on that one. Bringing that energy. Oh, getting to know each other, talking long distance, that kind of thing. What is the chance they're wanting to take? Is that actually meeting face to face for the first time? Bottom of the deck. Oh, they're very self-conscious. They're worried about appearance. So it may be that we're meeting somebody for the first time, guys. First time. This is insinuating we've talked to them probably, you know, in conversations and stuff, but this isn't, you know, they're building up to a meetup because they're so worried about how do I look? Am I on my A game here? Ooh, okay. But like I said, it is showing getting to know each other, learning more about each other. So yeah, let's come in on this. Let's take a chance here. But how safe is this? Oh, calling in your soulmate, your prayers and affirmations. So the person is feeling good. We've got a reconciliation. What's that about? Hold on, guys. Playfulness. Playfulness. Hold on, because I didn't get anything off of a reconciliation. Do I need to pull on it? Wouldn't hurt for a minute. Let's get a tarot deck. Tell me what's the reconciliation. For some of us, did we break up long distance? Not ever, and you know, had the long distance relationship, never really, you know, met each other. Did we break up for a minute? Because we got that playfulness of coming back into that playfulness. Emperor, Eight of Pentacles. Yeah, ooh, there was a break for a minute. Yeah. Queen of Wands. Aries energy, a lot of Aries energy. Feeling a little defeated on the bottom of the deck. Yes. Taking back what's mine. This would indicate that if we, you know, did we have a time away where we didn't talk to each other? If it did, it's insinuating the person was having to focus in on like work or project or education. We did get the student over here where we had to, you know, we weren't able to communicate as much. There was a little bit of a break, but all of a sudden the energy after the break, they are ready. They're like, yes, whatever it was, they achieved a certain amount of what they needed. Like I said, it could be work, a project, something like that, that went well, but they had to get full focus to it. Hopefully that makes sense. And hopefully that was confirmation for someone. So we did, you know, we do have coming back into this playfulness over here. I'm under your spell. It is safe for you to love. Open your heart to give and receive the highest energy of all with deception. Oh, what's the deception? What's the deception, guys? Are we picking? Okay, where I was saying they are trying to evaluate. We are going to find out anything that was we weren't authentic about. Past life relationship, they're filling it with us. Staying optimistic also about your love life and new love. It's definitely a new love, and it's just getting over. First initially meeting, finding out, have we been deceptive about each other, you know, anything about ourselves, that kind of thing. Codependency on the bottom of the deck. What's codependency got to do? Ooh, wedding, commitment, and flirt. The wedding, it says give your relationship a chance. Okay. So their full attention is now back. Whatever it was, the wedding card doesn't always insinuate I'm married to someone else. It can insinuate this. I have responsibilities that I need, that I'm wedded to. Kind of energy that I got to handle. I got obligations, responsibility, and I know I can't falter on them. And it would have something to do with what they rely on. Could be job, career, that kind of thing. Let's keep going here. Let's find out a little bit more for my Scorpios. Let's come in on this, taking a leap of faith. Is it safe? Is it safe? Ow, pet peeves. Irritated easily, list of annoyances, frequent complaints, and apology. Oh, okay. So they may be, I got a sense this person apologizes and they assume they get on your nerves or they're doing something that got on your nerves and they'll apologize a lot. Lost soul over here. Not so much of a lost soul as a lone soul, but they may be feeling lost without the connection with you. Past trauma. Ooh, why? They worried about the no compatibility. What happens? No wonder they're so self-conscious over here about appearance and everything, because they've evidently done this before. We've got love bombing on the bottom of the deck. Wins affection, then abandons. That may be their biggest concern, guys, because we're picking up the past trauma. They're being very self-conscious. Is it safe? Is this a safe connection for me? Can I believe in the magic of it? But what happens if we meet and there's no compatibility? And what if I find out that you're just a love bomber? Ow! Okay, we got them stressed out here. How soon are we getting ready to meet with each other? Because this is high stress. It's an indication right before when you get the butterflies and the nervousness of going on stage. Over here, we've got memorized. They are definitely memorized and enchanted by you. That card also insinuates that. And love letter, wanting to express the love. Wanting to express the love. But they are single. They are single, guys. And they may be coming out of, I thought, you know, my life would be good because we do have past trauma of, you know, I'll be single from now on. But there's a little bit more building to it. Oh, it's disordered. And lessons. Oh, okay, yeah. Lessons from the past have taught them, you know, I might want to stay single, but you teaching them something new because they're a little bit drunk in love over here. Scorpios, guys, let's go ahead and get their energy moving. Let's see what deck they want to put some energy on to. Oh, got this one. Hang on, energy's still moving. This one. Energy's still moving though. Hold on. This one. Okay, we're getting three different ones. We'll take it. We will take it. Scorpios person, Scorpios. Talk to us. Let's get it loosey-goosey here. Talk to it. Oh, pop. I'm wary of becoming just one of many. One of many. Is it safe for me to love you the way I'm loving you? No. You have no idea what you can do to me. You remind me of someone else. Trigger. Yeah, they're definitely being triggered from the past. Past experiences. I want to be there with you. You're making it really hard to stay away. Here I go. I said, I would never fall again. The lessons. I want to get to know you better. I need to tell you that I'm sorry. Guys, all the sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Like I said, I feel like they feel like they get on your nerves. They did something that irritated you. I'm so sorry. I feel special when you open up to me. It was not just your looks that attracted me. I know what I want. I want you. Are you feeling it too? I'm affected more than you know. Ooh. Oh, what was this one? Okay. Scorpio's person. Scorpio. Let's get a shuffle on this one. It's big enough for me to shuffle, guys. Yes. Talk to us. I miss you like crazy. I know I can make you so happy. I feel like I have known you forever. I don't want you to sacrifice what's important to you. I love you so much. Things have become too stressful and boring between us. It's very passive, so they're asking you that question. Have things become too stressful or boring between us? I'm beyond crazy about you. Just so you'll know before you answer that question. Beyond crazy. Please don't doubt our connection. It's real. It's real. Let's go ahead and get the other deck. It's from my Scorpios. Their person. Talk to us, Pop. You could turn me on with just a touch. Do you ever think of me? If you only knew how much I love you. You're everything I ask for in my prayers. I would never hold you down. I would cherish your happiness. Anything else? Scorpio just pop. You're what I can't live without. I can't get enough of you. I can't think straight around you though. And you know you could break my heart. Ooh. Scorpios, I hope it was helpful, guys. Y'all stay blessed.